words in relation to the ayahs that we read, or just in general, nasiha. Today, we'll just say a few things that are connected to both. You know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in these particular ayahs, really makes his qudra apparent, you know, and his capability and his power and his authority very much clear in these ayahs. And some of the ayat of the Quran are like that, where Allah's attributes are just on full display, and he does not boast. He is only speaking the truth about his attributes in the Quran. Among the things that's mentioned in these ayahs is just that the authority and also the reality of our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, understanding his authority and the reality of how we understand it or we don't understand it, how that manifests. Those that don't understand it, it's as though Allah says their hearts have been covered, and their spiritual reality in the akhirah will reflect that they will have hearts that are covered and deaf and blind. And this is something that we need to just be mindful of while we have our sight and our abilities and our capabilities and our health in this life, to make sure that we don't spiritually close our hearts off, because then in the akhirah our hearts will actually literally manifest like that. And so alhamdulillah, in the month of Ramadan is one of the most profound opportunities we have in our life, and may Allah give us a long life so we have several Ramadans in our life. But whenever we're allowed to enter the month of Ramadan, it's always an opportunity to recalibrate and to reset and to cleanse. And to cleanse the heart so that it can receive all of the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or at least some of them, or more of them than the days and nights that preceded the month of Ramadan. One of the ways that the scholars say is the easiest way to do that is to reflect upon death. And I know that this is not always easy for youth to do, but it's important that you reflect on our mortality and on your mortality, and on really the attributes of Allah giving things a beginning and Allah giving things an end. If thinking about death or thinking about things like that are too depressing for you, then reflect upon the attributes of Allah giving you life and Allah having the same capability of removing that life. You know, and these are the things that we should be reflecting about in order to make sure that the attributes of Allah are magnified in our heart. The Prophet ﷺ said, and others have said things similar, that remember death often, and death is the thing that eliminates distraction, essentially, distractions of this world. So one of the ways that we do that as well, that can facilitate that, is just measuring our time by the days that have elapsed, right? And we've already reached the second Jummah of Ramadan. You know, this Ramadan is blessed. I believe there's five. So we began on Jummah and now we're on the second Jummah. So 7 days have elapsed already. And you have to now reevaluate what have we done in this life, right? If we imagine it to be a metaphorical representation of the entirety of our life, what have we done since the beginning, last Friday, and what have we done since the end? How much good have we done? How much have we fallen short? Right? How much have we taken advantage of the barakah and the time of Ramadan? How much have we understood the benefit of the night and the prayer and worship and dhikr in the month of Ramadan from its beginning to its end? And we evaluate and we spend time thinking and reflecting, no matter our age. And then we begin new again from this Ramadan with the hope that we receive the next Ramadan, the next Jummah in Ramadan. And we begin again to take advantage and learn from our previous quote-unquote life. You know, what have we done and what did we not do? And now we apply more in these next few days. And then next Jummah, we reflect again that another week has passed. What have I done? What have I not done? What do I need to make amends for and ask Allah to forgive? What do I make intention for to do more good of? Right? And then likewise, the next Jummah and the next Jummah and the next Jummah. But like we mentioned a few days ago, that the people of Allah measure their life in the number of breaths that Allah has allotted for them. And so every breath that we've taken since last Jummah until now has left and it won't return. And so we need to just reflect. Ramadan will go by very, very quickly. And just also, I would just ask my youngest friends that are listening to not get distracted by ni'mah. You know, mashallah, we're in the midst of this pandemic, and it can feel like now it doesn't feel anymore, And because we have electricity and we have fan and we have food and we have all of these blessings upon blessings, blessings can be a distraction from the reality of the world as well. There are still people dealing with great hardship. People that you may know that are not sharing it with you. People whom you may know who know others, right, that are not very far removed from your own life. So don't relax. Don't allow now the blessings to distract you from the reality that Allah right now, subhanAllah, has the world in His grips. And there is people dealing with great fitna and great struggle. And so remember them in your dua. Don't allow the comforts of your home and the comforts of technology or the distractions of technology to have you lose sight of the reality of Allah's majesty and power in these days and these nights. So this is my reminder to myself and to all of you that we've already gone through 1 week in the month of Ramadan. We were together last Friday and now we arrive on this Friday. For us to spend some portion of today evaluating what we've done in those 7 days and what do we hope to do in the coming 7 days, and make amends for things that we've fallen short on and make intentions to things that we want to increase in. And likewise, measure every day and every night, and certainly every week to week, as the month of Ramadan will be coming close to an end very, very quickly. And I worry that, you know, this opportunity that we have in our homes and in our company of our family, that we'll, once we're allowed to kind of leave these circumstances, that we didn't take advantage. So may Allah make it easy for all of you to reflect upon your mortality, and also to reflect upon how and the ways that you can increase your himma, your aspiration. And on this day, we just ask you to remember all of your loved ones and people that you may not know personally in your dua. We know, mashallah, several people who are struggling right now, dealing with great hardship, emotional and spiritual. And so we ask you to just remember people in your dua. If you don't know anyone who's in hardship or in difficulty, then just make a jami'a dua to include those people who are, because there are many people. So please make a lot of salawat on the Prophet ﷺ as well today. Make sure that you try your best to pray the Dhuha prayer with your families in your home. Make the adhan, make preparations, dress up, smell nice, perfume yourself. If you have a space in the home that you can set aside for prayer, put out the prayer mats and establish a jamaat in the home for Dhuha prayer, and honor and celebrate the day of Jummah, and as well as the month of Ramadan as well. So we pray that you have a wonderful day. Yesterday or today, we've been sending out the information about our Ramadan door challenge. I'll just end with a few points on that. So the Sanad Ramadan door challenge is something that we've started today or this month and this year. And what it's intended to do is to first and foremost celebrate Ramadan and make sure that people remain happy and festive and celebratory, even though we're in our homes, that the family get together. And we want everybody to get involved, young or old, whether you have children or you don't have children, whether you're single or married. We want everyone to get involved. And the ask is basically that you just feel a sense of joy in Ramadan and that you bring a little bit of the sunshine of Ramadan into your home. And it's a simple challenge. We're asking everyone to decorate their doors. We initially were saying bedroom doors, but we've opened it up to any door that you want. It could be your garage door, your front door, your bedroom door. And just, you know, really celebrate Ramadan. Be colorful, be festive, be happy. And take a picture. And if you want to share a little note as to what your motivations were or something that will bring happiness to the heart of anyone who might read it, take a picture, share that note, and then post it on social media, Instagram or elsewhere, using the hashtag Ramadan Door Challenge. And we're hoping people will do that. Our family is going to be posting ours today, and we want all of the Sanad Prep families and any family around the world that's listening to join this. And we want to make it a global sensation, the Sanad Ramadan Door Challenge. We want everybody to get involved, and we hope that it brings a little bit of joy to our community and the Ummah of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And we hope that people who are not even of our faith see it and find joy and happiness in our happiness, inshallah. So we thank you all. We hope that you'll join the Ramadan Door Challenge. We hope that you'll remember us in your dua. And we ask you to send a lot of salawat on the Prophet and remember those who are in more difficult circumstances than you always, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.